Akropoli. Komentar meh, komentar meh. Nggak dingin, Miss. Nggak dingin nih. Hah? Lebih dingin Venice. Jauh. Mau gue fotoin? Nih. Hah? Ini mau buka desa aja, gue fotoin. Iya, Pak. Mana?
Bentar, Pak.
Salju tuh nggak sedingin yang kita kira ya. Mungkin salju di Athens sekali nggak dingin, Mei. Di luar dingin. Ya kan? Komentar, Mei, Mei. Mana?
This afternoon, as we're going to drive back in Athens, we're going to be on the other side of the road. Wow, everywhere snow. And I would like to tell you that the biggest part of the village, as it is pedestrian, if you see through the houses, there are steps. Small paths leading people up to the highest point of the village. The only problem of the drive here is double direction single road. There's not any other road. So look over there. There is a bus stuck. It stopped here at the corner. So we have to wait. The other bus to come on this side, and we are able to go through the village. It's not, we're not complaining here, eh? Even if we're stuck in the village.
Slowly. Five buses, coaches, with 50, okay, we are 2018, but doesn't matter. You know, the other buses are filled with people. It's the weekend, so it's always, you know, the busiest. These trees, which look so empty today, no leaves, nothing. White berry trees. White berry. My old friends, old pals. Decorating the exterior walls. And I will show you in a few minutes again. I'm not sure if you can see the road, which gets higher to the ski resort. A little bit foggy. No, we cannot see. Look over there, up higher. There is kind of a line. The line, the stripe, that's the road. Up higher, here in front of us. Over there, where is the tunnel? Where is the pillar? You see the pillar? Can you see everybody on the right hand side? Up higher. reel on this boat. Over there, now it's on the left, huh? You see there is like a tunnel with pillars, like a structure. Over there is the road. That's on the other side. How many meters is the height of the ski resort? 1,400 meters. 1,400 meters. It's 400 meters above the village. Oh, you agree with me, it's very impressive, eh? All the snow. Okay, now in about 10 minutes, we get to the site. We first visit the site of Delphi, then the museum. So in case it's a very bad weather, you can go to the museum after. I will give you the entrance tickets. You have to keep your tickets because there is one, the same ticket you use for the site and the museum. Because first we see the site, then the museum. We're going to see what to the site. First of all, please, very careful, eh? Mind your step. Because you have to walk a little bit higher from the steps, then a little bit the path. So as you get down again, you have to be very, very careful, eh? During your free time. We get higher from the archaeological site, the entrance, where I give you your tickets, to the agora. The first building we stop, the structure we see, as first will be the agora. Agora was a marketplace, the place where the visitors and pilgrims bought the animals to sacrifice first of all in front of the temple, before getting inside the temple, entering the temple. Then statues, gifts, offerings, like to offer to God Apollo, they bought it from the small shops of the agora. The agora has been transformed into a church in the centuries, 80s. That's why we're going to see blocks of marble with Christian crosses on. After the agora, you walk higher. We're going to walk exactly the same way of ancient time. It was called the Sacred Way. The Sacred Way, first part, was decorated with statues. 50 and 50 statues for less than 50 meters. I will show you now the bases and pedestals today. In front of us, the columns is the temple. Above is the theater of used for musical performances and theatrical plays, because above all, here they worship the god of music, God Apollo. And the structure, you can see just one single building. The only building completed is the treasury house of the Athenians. Treasury house, where they used to keep inside the objects offered by the citizens from Athens. In front of us, there is a small spring fountain called Castalia Fountain, the purification spot for the ancient visitors and pilgrims, Castalia. And now, please follow me. We stop in 2 minutes. We get from the steps to the entrance of the site. I'll give you the entrance ticket. I think it's a good idea if you have umbrellas to take your umbrella with you, because it's a little bit of drops. I'm not sure it's going to be the rainstorm, but still, if you have a jacket, something, which is also a little bit cold, but not as cold as the village. Okay, 5 minutes after 2 o'clock, we shall.
Katofen di belakang. Nih. Katofen. Gila, puing-puing doang bisa dijual.
There are some archaeological sites, you can see a lot of dogs. Here you are, the portico into a church. And that's why, yeah? Can you see everybody? Some beautiful, huh? Christian crosses. You can see on the left, on 1, 2, 3, huh? At least 3 blocks of marble. with Christian crosses on. You remember? In many places, when people change religion, they would like to purify this or the other particular ancient place, and that's why. Temples have been...
T-H-O-L-O-S, Tholos. Tholos was a rounded, circular building. Nowadays we can see only the three columns, serviced order. And who offered the Tholos? The Athenians. The Athenians down there, why they put it down?
Delphi.
That was revealed the secret by God Apollo, unfortunately. God Apollo was on the side of the treasure.
Yeah.
one of the giants. Most of these songs have got to select great actor, unknown artist, 5 or 25
there.
And let's start on the right.